There could be a lot of reasons of why you would want to send your project to somebody, or even why you would want to take a look at somebody else's project inside of your configuration. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can use our database management tools and go through the process of exporting and importing a project. Now, this is also really helpful too when reaching out to tech support. They might need some information to troubleshoot the issue that you got going on. So you're going to need to know how to export something from your database. Hope you're ready. Let's get into this next lesson of Microvellum Toolbox. All right, let's get into our database management tools. Under Options, Utilities, and Database Management. Now, this is where you're going to want to go if you need to import or export anything, whether it be projects or products. Especially when it comes to working with our technical support, they may ask you for things that you need to export from your machine and send over to them. There may also be a situation where you may have a project that you want to export and send it to somebody else so they can import it into their configuration. So that's actually what we're going to do in this one. We're going to go through our list of projects and look for one that we can send off to a colleague. We got this one here. Let's see, test your knowledge. We got to send somebody this project on testing their knowledge on learning everything about Toolbox. As you select the project, you'll see over here the database records that appear. I have selected projects and the materials that are included in that project. Now, if there's not any project-specific materials, you may not need to include this in the exported file, or the SDF file, as we call it. So if you want, you can always just right-click on that and remove the selected item. So now the only items inside of this window here will be the ones that are exported from this configuration. And if there is more than one, you can select multiple projects. It doesn't have to be just one. Now, if you do select more, so for example, if we selected this one also, we'll have our two projects. And again, the materials, whether or not you wanted to keep that. But as that gets imported into a new configuration, what's going to happen is these two projects will be separated. They're not going to be like combined or anything into one project. It's going to be imported as a folder. It'll even say import folder. And then within that, you'll have the one or multiple projects that you've selected. So those selected materials came back. Just make sure you remove those again. Now into export from current configuration to selected target, you're going to want to make sure that you just browse to somewhere and select your target location of where you want that export file to go. And then the database name, I typically like to give it something unique so I can find it easily. So MBU test export. Now in the options, we can check these boxes. So do we want to zip up the exported items, transfer all the hardware drawings, delete the projects after export? That's an option as well. I typically leave all these unchecked and just hit transfer. Okay, the export's complete. Let's go to our file explorer. We got it in my desktop. So because of the Microvellum export having that name to it, I can find it. Now inside we have our project, right? But that's only the drawing. We actually don't even really need that. It's there, but the main thing is this SDF file. This SDF file is the one that you're going to send to your buddy or somebody at tech support. Okay, now we can close out of this. We don't need to close out a Toolbox. I'm just going to open up my projects list here. So you can see right now we have what, 6 folders. Okay, so that's the folder structure that we currently have. Now, let's say that you're on a different configuration now. Maybe you've opened up your sandbox configuration or somebody else has opened up their own, and they're going to want to now import that project that they just received. Under Utilities, same thing. Go back to our database management tools. Now, select Import. Now, it's taking me to my desktop where I have that Microvellum export file. So there it is, the SDF file. Remember, that's the one that we want to grab. Hit Open. And it's just asking, do you want to keep all the database records? Remember, those were the selected projects and materials. We deleted the materials, so they're just the selected projects. But if there are more than one, I typically like to say yes here, so it's going to import everything. So it also grabbed the tool file, which is automatic. That's not something we saw in there, but it just automatically comes in with that tool file. And because we selected all of them, we still have the same option to remove that selected item. So before we actually transfer everything into this database, I don't want to have a duplicate tool file. I already have that one. So I'm going to remove that selected tool file, make sure that I have my project, and hit transfer. Okay, so because I'm in a configuration that has a project with this name, I'm just importing it back into the same configuration. So it's not going to be the way that maybe you or somebody else is going to be doing it. But if there is a project that has the same name, you have the option to skip, replace, or keep both, which is what we're going to do, and then give this one a new name. Now that's complete. It's always a good idea to restart Toolbox. Let's go ahead and do that. And back into our project tree, you can see how we have that additional folder now been added called imported. And there's the new project. Now at this point, you can also rename it if you wanted to rename your project or get it out of that imported folder and put it into your own. So that's the process of exporting a project and importing it into a configuration. All right, well, that'll wrap up another training lesson. So hopefully that helped you understand a little bit more on using your database management tools and how you can export or import anything inside of your database. So until next time, keep creating those extraordinary things with ease using Microvellum Toolbox.